2, Point and Click Hell's playthrough of the Blackwell Legacy. I said Chronicles. This is Magna Carta, and this is part 4. So let's get started. We just met Joey, and...
So you're a ghost.
Yep.
You're a ghost. Yeah. There's a ghost in my apartment.
Hey, you're sharp. Took your aunt and grandmother ages to work that out.
Why have you been haunting my family?
Haunting? Is that what I'm doing? That's a real ugly word.
Answer me, why are you here?
You got me, sweetheart. I've been wondering why me and why your family since this whole gig started. Must be some kind of gift your family has.
A gift?
You're a medium. A medium with a direct connection with the spirit world. And I, my dear, have the unique pleasure of being that connection.
I don't understand any of this.
Oh, you will, babe, you will. Took your aunt a while, but she got the hang of it. Your grandmother never really caught on. That's probably why...
Why what?
Why she didn't last long. But that's something we can talk about later. You felt something today, didn't you?
Felt something?
Yeah, you felt sick to your stomach, I saw you.
I've been feeling sick all day.
And where did it start?
You mean the dog run?
Yeah, that's where we've gotta go.
What, right now?
Yep, the sooner the better.
But it's the middle of the night.
So you've just had a nice nap. You should be ready for action.
I'm not going out to Washington Square Park in the middle of the night.
Well, that's where you're wrong. If there's any reason behind this medium business, it's to take care of problems like your dog park. And we have to take care of them soon.
We've got to go right now?
Yes.
What's the hurry?
Let me put it another way. Do you want to end up like your aunt and grandmother?
Was that because of you? Did you do that?
Not me, kid, not me. I didn't make him that way, and I don't know what did. But do you really want to sit around here and find out?
Fine. Let's go.
That's the spirit. After you.
That was strange. Everybody just ignored you. Am I the only one who can see you?
Yep, and hear me. So keep your voice low. Oh yeah, this is the spot. Can you see it?
I don't see anything. Can we go?
Come on, this way.
Hey, wait!
Don't worry, I can't travel far from you. It goes against the rules, whatever they are. Now look inside there, and look close.
What am I supposed to see?
Just wait. It'll come.
Ooh, it's a ghost!
Okay. Wait, I see something. Who is that?
That's what we're here to find out. I'll talk to the spook. You can stay here.
Okay.
Now watch and learn. Why so down, beautiful? Ah. I'm a bit out of practice. How should I handle this? Hey, buck up! It's only death! The worst part's over! Leaving so soon? I thought we were getting along.
They all run. It's so hard to hold on. It's me! It's me, they won't stop!
We're here to help you.
Help?
Yeah, that's us. We're helpers.
Help. Help. He wants me to help him. But I want to help them. Don't they know that?
Help who?
Can't. They run away.
We won't run away.
No.
No, we're sick! He poisoned us! Got into our head and poisoned us.
Whatever happened, darling, it's over. You do know that, don't you?
No. I'm poisoned. Stay away or I'll poison you! Run! Run away like all the others!
You're beautiful when you're angry. Has anyone told you?
No. You won't trap me again.
Again?
He made everyone go away. There is nobody else. You're him!
Who?
Him!
Now look, darling. Sweetheart.
Leave me.
Hey.
Leave.
All right. we're going. Look, just sit tight. We'll figure this out, and we'll be back.
That went not so good.
Friggin' ghosts. Can't get a straightforward answer out of any of them.
What just happened?
What just happened is we've got an unstable spirit on our hands, haunting that dog park over there. You wondered why the mutts don't like it here? That's the reason.
There's a ghost haunting the dog park.
That's what I said.
A ghost.
Sure.
What am I doing here?
I told you.
No. No. I really should go to bed.
Hey, wait a sec.
Yeah, sleep. I shouldn't be here.
Oh, for the love of Pete.
Day two.
What an odd dream.
Good morning, Bright Eyes.
You're still here.
Wouldn't be anywhere else. Has anybody told you that you snore?
I do not snore.
Like a chainsaw, darling. I'd be a little hacked off if I actually slept.
So this is going to be my life from now on?
Pretty much, yeah.
You're going to follow me around for the rest of my life.
That's how it works, as far as I can tell.
Great. Just great.
Hey, it ain't all a bed of roses for me either, dollface. You think I chose to be shackled to your family for the last 40 years? Your grandmother refused to accept it, and look what happened to her.
And Auntie?
She made a mistake.
What kind of mistake?
Hey, what is this, 20 questions? What's with the third degree?
Are you hiding something, Joey?
Who, me? I'm an open book. It's not my fault you can't read.
What does that mean?
It means zip it.
Look, this isn't easy, you know. You're a ghost? Fine. I'm a medium? Fine. My whole life is turned upside down? Fine. But you could at least meet me halfway.
You've accepted it, you say?
So far, yes.
You've only seen a taste of it. Are you ready to go all the way?
What do you mean?
Ready to see what's out there. Ready to see what this is all about.
There's more?
Oh, yes.
So what is it?
I don't have to tell you. It's best if I show you.
You better keep your pants on, mister.
Here, take a hold of this.
I can touch it?
Yeah, the only part of me you can touch, unfortunately.
It kinda tingles. What is it?
The stuff of life. Or death. I've never quite worked it out.
What now?
Now you pull.
Pull the tie?
Yeah, pull.
Okay.
The only thing it has you can pull.
Oh my god. Where have you taken me?
Relax. Take your time. It's a lot to take in at once.
What is this place?
It's the doorway to infinity, darling. Out there, in the distance, the next world. The next plane of existence. The gossamer threads that separate this world from the next. Whatever you want to call it. It's all out there.
How did we get here?
We're inside your head.
You mean I'm dreaming?
No, I mean we're literally inside your head. Remember those headaches you had yesterday?
Yeah.
That was your power awakening. Or to be more specific, it was this place, forcing its way into your mind.
Forcing its way in?
Is that dangerous?
Maybe. I don't know.
I'm not sure I like this.
Well, like it or not, we're here.
So what does this place actually do?
It's sort of a transfer point, or node. It connects the mortal world with the next. You bring spirits into this place, and then send them on their merry way.
That's it.
Well, there's a bit more to it than that.
I thought as much.
You see, many ghosts aren't as lucid as myself. Most can barely tell you their own names, let alone tell you what's wrong. Near as I can figure, they have to come to terms with their departure before they can actually depart. You dig me so far?
I think so. The ghosts don't know they're dead.
Yeah, right. So, we have to help them accept it. Once they accept their death, they are much more willing to move on. That's my job, see? I talk to the spooks. They trust me more because I'm one of them. You do the legwork.
See?
Anyway, I know you have some questions about this place, so go ahead and ask them.
What about you? Can you go through that whole...
I wish, darling. But I can't. I've tried before, but it just spits me back out. I'm stuck here, whether I like it or not.
You're wearing your tie again. How did that happen?
Not sure. Near as your aunt and me figured, the tie is just an extension of whatever power brought us here. It's not a real physical tie. No more than I am a real physical person.
But that makes no sense.
Look, just accept it, dollface. Forget logic. For you, logic went out the window the day I appeared in your bedroom. There ain't no instruction manual for this. Your aunt and me just figured it out as we went along.
It came with an instruction... Oh, you mean that. Never mind.
Are you okay, Joey?
Me? I'm dandy.
You don't look all right.
It's just this place. I don't like it. Probably because I don't belong. Maybe someday, but not now.
What about that ghost in the park? The one from last night? Why didn't we bring her here?
First of all, I didn't think you were ready. And secondly, that ghost was too lost and confused. When a ghost is like that, I can't just force the tie into their hands. It won't work, don't ask me why. They have to know they're dead first. Your aunt called it, being spiritually ready.
I think I've learned enough.
You sure?
Yeah.
All right, let's get out of here.
Trippy.
Welcome back.
Ugh.
Take it easy. It's a little disorientating.
I'm fine. So what now? Go back to the park and bring her to... that place?
You got it.
And how do we do that?
There are three steps. First, we have to find out more about her. Second, we use that information to get through to her, convince her that she's dead. And three, help her move on.
How do we find out more about her? She could be any...
Not necessarily. That picture you got, the one of the three girls? That blonde girl is either the ghost in the park or her twin sister.
You sure?
She's a dead ringer. No pun intended.
The blonde girl is dead.
Looks like it.
And this other girl, Joanne, she's dead too.
Yep.
What's going on?
That, my dear, is our bread and butter.
What else can we do to learn more about the ghost in the park?
The photo, dear. It's the biggest clue we have.
How do we convince ghosts that they're actually dead?
That's the tricky part. Near as I can figure, we need to remind the ghosts who they are. Their death was too traumatic or too violent or too emotional that their little spirit minds snapped. So we need to do whatever we can to bring them back to themselves.
And how do we do that?
Usually by finding something that has a personal significance to them. Could be an object, a piece of information, or even another person.
So we need to know more about the ghost in the park.
You're a writer, yeah? Think of this as the ultimate character study.
How do we help a ghost move on?
With my magic tie, dear. I give one end to the spook, the other end to you. You pull the ghost in, and you send them on their way.
You don't come in with me?
No, sorry. That's your job.
I think I've heard enough.
Yeah, let's get going.
All right.
You coming?
Yeah, sure.
Like he has a choice. Alright, I think by the time we get to Brittany Hall... we're gonna go ahead and call it a day. Alright, thanks for watching. This has been part 4 of the Blackwell Legacy. We'll catch you next time. Thanks.